The 23rd Sunday after Pentecost, Year B. From the Book of Ruth. Where you go, I will go. Where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God. In the name of that same God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. In our readings for this week, the letter to the Hebrews describes the tent of Jesus' entire being as the greater and perfect tent, of which earthly places of worship are but lesser, imperfect images. Because Jesus enters the inner tent with his own blood as an offering, blood we share with Jesus in our common humanity and in our sacraments. This passage creates an image of our lives, too, as that outer space we pass through, and our deaths as the curtain hanging between that space and the next one. Our lives are therefore not ended when we pass through that curtain, but rather magnified and perfected, even though it may seem to those left behind, like the psalmist, that when we breathe our last, we return to earth, and in that day our thoughts perish. When, therefore, Jesus and the scribe discuss in our gospel the first commandment, to love the Lord our God with all that we have, that all is not constrained by our death. Instead, death opens to us a space that has been hidden from us throughout our earthly life, a space in which we are enabled to offer our own blemished beings to God, because Jesus first offered himself without blemish. Therefore, let us not shudder and turn back from death, as Naomi in her bitterness urges her daughters-in-law to turn back to their own people and gods when death has taken away their husbands. Let us instead cling to Jesus as Ruth clings to Naomi. For where we will go, Jesus has gone before us. The place where we now lodge, Jesus has created and lodged in before us. He's taken us as his people, humbled himself to worship our God as we do, though he himself is that same God. And where we die, he himself has died and been buried. When our God becomes flesh, allowing us to do thus and so to him and more as well, how can we dare then to believe that death would part such a God from us? Let us likewise consider and give thanks for the lives of all who have gone before us, pointing the way for us. Let us pray for their eternal rest in the Lord, as we ourselves hope to rest in the most holy name of our God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.